So a cosine,
I gotta remember
of
this.
Theta equals negative 2 over 5. Cosine is what?
I don't know. It's the cosine.
But what does like cosine represent?
I don't know. I'm got a math me. I got this. If you tell me, I'm just going to forget. Like
the adjacent over hypotenuse, right?
So it's a toa.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the cicatawa.
Okay, so if we have this triangle, let's just say this is angle theta, adjacent over the hypotenuse. This is 5. And that's 2. Mm-hmm. Right?
Yeah.
Theta's the angle. So now we're looking for sine, so we need to figure out what this one is, right? So, we know that the hypotenuse is still going to be 5, and sine is opposite over hypotenuse, so sine of theta equals x over 5, right?
Si.
Si.
Si, mama.
Okay. Theta is greater than 0. Okay. So it means we're also in
the whole website.
So if cosine is negative, that means we're in this quadrant, right? So cosine is also going to be bigger than.
Yeah, this is another.
Okay. Does that make sense since this is negative? Okay.
You can't do Google
Caution
for internet, can you? Like Google.
Okay. Yeah. So, are you allowed to use a calculator on here
now? I don't know.
You don't know?
Oh, yeah. I don't even know. You can't track it, I can tell you that.
Oh, yeah.
Huh? Or it was
they can't tell if you're using a calculator.
Okay, so, I don't know if you're allowed to, but for this, if you take inverse cosine, so if you did, and then cosine. This will cancel, and this will give you what theta is equal to. Theta is equal to inverse cosine of negative 2 over 5. When you do that,
math. This is math. Math.
Yes. No.
I'm probably putting this to good use. Because I bought this
So inverse cosine of negative 2 over 5, the angle is equal to 113 degrees, which is
negative 2 over 5 equals 100 what?
Inverse cosine of negative 2 over 5 equals 113 degrees.
Oh,
or if you wanted to convert that to radians, that would be pi. So once you have that angle, you know that theta is equal to 113.578 degrees, right? You can plug this into here. So sine.
That's an 8.
Yeah. Sine of 113.578 degrees is equal to x over 5. From here, you can multiply by 5. That'll cancel, and then you can solve for what x is equal to. So if you do 5 times sine of 113.578, it equals x is equal to 4.58, right?
Yeah.
So you have 4.58 over. Five. No, go ahead. Is equal to this. So your answer is this number. I'm not sure which one of these numbers is that, but
the square root. Yeah, it's definitely this one because the square root of 25 is 5, obviously, right?
And yeah, perfect.
So just give out that one. Yeah, that's good. So what about this one right here? Is this one some good stuff? Because I don't know how to do any of these.
Give me 1 second. I just turn her in.
Okay.
Try to get this.
Don't worry, it's not a fisheye. You can't see you. if I point it towards you.
It sees you.
So this is telling you what the adjacent and opposite angle are of this. So use that to try to figure out what theta is. You know what the tangent theta is equal to because they gave you the opposite and adjacent side. So figure out what theta is from there, and then you can plug it into cosine.